गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल रीड आवर न्यू पोएम द टेल ऑफ कस्टर्ड द ड्रैगन। दिस पोएम इज कंपोज्ड बाय ऑग्डन नेस। दिस पोएम इज रिटन ब्यूटिफुली एंड इट इज बेस्ड ओनली एंड ओनली ऑन पोएट्स इमेजिनेशन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट this poem stanza wise. In starting we are discussing about two stanza, first and second stanza. Belinda lived in a little white house with a little black kitten and a little grey mouse and a little yellow dog and a little red wagon and a Riolio Trullio little pet dragon. So dear student, if we are talking about the rhyming scheme of this poem, so we can see here house, mouse, wagon, dragon. So here A B B. This is the rhyme scheme for this stanza. In the first stanza, we are introduced to Belinda, who lives with her pets in a white house. These pets are a black kitten, a grey mouse, a yellow dog and a dragon. They all use a red wagon when they want to go out somewhere. So in second stanza, as we can see here, now the name of the little black kitten was Ink and the little grey mouse she called him Green and the little yellow dog was sharp as mustard but the dragon was a coward and she called him Custer. So in second stanza, as you can see here, the poet has beautifully introduced the name about the name of the pet animals. So this stanza describes the various pets and their color. The kitten being black is known as Ink, the mouse being tiny as Blink, the dog being yellow and as mustard and the dragon being cowardly as custard. Clear? So dear students, in third and fourth stanza we are reading the tale of Custard the Dragon. Custard the dragon had big sharp teeth and spikes on top of him and scales underneath, mouth like a fireplace, chimney for a nose, and Riolio Trullio daggers on his toes. So it is the basic information about a dragon. Dear students, as we know that dragon, according to the Chinese myth, it is an animal just like we can say dinosaurs. Okay, so just like a dinosaur, it looking and it can fly also, and whenever it open its mouth, so from its mouth it is giving fire. So Custard the dragon had big sharp teeth. In this stanza we are told that the Custard was a full grown dragon and could easily defend himself against any danger. As we can see here, about its physical structure, with big sharp teeth, spike on top of him and scales underneath. Scales underneath means in the body part, under the belly, it had scales. So he had sharp teeth, spikes on his back, scales beneath his belly, and daggers like toys. Daggers means just we can say nukile bade tez naakhun. Okay, so he could also breathe fire. This is the specialty of this particular animal. In next stanza, as you can see here, Belinda was as brave as a barrel full of beers, and Ink and Blink chased lions down the stairs. Mustard was as brave as a tiger in a race, but Custard tried for a nice safe kiss. Here in this stanza, dear students, the poet has beautifully described about the nature which type of nature these animals, the particular girl or lady, Belinda, had. So, this stanza describes that Belinda, Ink, Blink and Mustard were all brave, even though they were much smaller in size. Means, in spite of smaller size, they have full courage. They have full courageous feelings, spirit, than the Custard. But that Custard was so cowardly that he preferred to be caged if that would keep him safe. So here we can say the poet has declared about their nature, but this is completely wrong, as we can see further, as we can see read further. So this is our third and fourth stanza. So dear students, here we are with stanza 5, 6 and 7. As you can see here, Belinda tickled him, she tickled him unmercifully. Ink, Blink and Mustard, they rudely called him Percival. They called laughing in the little red wagon at the Dealio Tulio cowardly dragon. So Belinda is tickling to Custard. Pareshan karne ke liye. And in an unmerciful way, in this stanza we are told that Belinda and the others all made fun of Custard for being so afraid all the time. क्योंकि वो हमेशा हर समय डरता रहता है. Belinda tickled him, and all pets ironically compared him with the brave knight called Percival, who had been in the service of King Arthur. Means they are making a fun of him that after being so strong and powerful, it was always demanding for his nice safe case. In next stanza, as we can see here, for this joke, Belinda giggled till she shook the house. Belinda is laughing very much, very loudly, that the whole house is shaking. And Blink said Blink, which is giggling for a mouse, and Blink is also giggling in a mouse way. Ink and Mustard rudely asked his age. They are asking about his age because he is so grown up, and still now he is demanding for a nice safe case. When Custard cried for a nice safe case, but still now Custard is demanding for the nice safe case so that he can live in his cave. Next is 7th stanza. So suddenly they hear a nasty sound. Suddenly all of them are alarmed or warned by hearing a nasty sound, and Mustard growled and they all looked around. Mustard, who was the dog, is growling and they all was looking around. Meow, cried Ink, and oh, cried Belinda. And now at this time Ink and Belinda both are crying. For there was a pirate climbing in the window, because now a pirate is entering in the house forcefully by the window. Here window means window. So they are afraid now. They are all afraid, and they are just in a confusion. What will be now? Okay. So next we are reading stanza number 7. 5, 6, 7 we have read. Now stanza number 8, 9, 10. So dear students, as you can see here in stanza number 8, 9 and 10, here suddenly when they all are making a fun on Custer the dragon, they hear suddenly a noise, a nasty sound, and they found that a pirate entered in the house forcefully, and the pirate's intention was not good. Pistol in his left hand, pistol in his right, means in both hands the pirate hold the pistol, and he held in his teeth a cutlass blade, a sort type of sword. So in his teeth he had a sword also. His beard was black, or leg was wood. Here in this line the physical description is here for the pirate. So his beard was black and one leg was wood. It was clear that the pirate meant no good. Means here the pirate's intention was not good. It was clear for Belinda, Mustard, Ink, Blink and Custer. Belinda paled. Paled means due to fear or afraid of. He was pale. She was pale and she cried, "Help, help." She was demanding help. She was crying for help. But Mustard fled with a terrified air. When Mustard the dog heard this voice, "Help, help," it fled with a terrified yell. Ink trickled down to the bottom of the household. Ink was going also, was also hiding himself in the household, and little mouse Blink steadily mouse hole, और जो छोटा mouse था Blink वो भी अपने bill में जाकर छुप जाता है. But up jumped Custard snarling like an engine की तरह गुर्राते हुए Custard सामने आता है. Clashed his tail like irons in a dungeon, और अपनी पूंछ को एक लोहे की छड़ की तरह आवाज करता हुआ, with a clatter and a clank and a jangling squirrel, बिल्कुल अपनी अटैकिंग मोड में आते हुए, he went at the pirate like a robin at a worm. See the Custard, pirate की तरफ जा रहा है, जैसे कि रोबिन एक पक्षी होता है जो सीधा कीड़े पर झपटता है. In the same way, Custard the dragon is attacking on the pirate. Clear? So, dear students, here in these stanzas 11th and 12th, we can see here fight between pirate and dragon. So, the pirate get at Belinda's dragon. Pirate जो था वो Belinda के dragon की तरफ झपटा and gulped some grog from his pocket flagon. And here the pirate is consuming alcohol from his pocket flagon because he was not accepting this attack. So he fired two bullets but they didn't hit. So now pirate is firing two bullets but unfortunately, or we can say coincidentally, they didn't hit to Custard, and Custard gobbled him every bit, and Custard attacked on pirate and and cut him into the pieces. Now Belinda embraced him, Mustard licked him. Now Belinda is embracing him, Mustard is like licking him. No one mourned for his pirate victim. No one was sorrowful. No one was expressing their grief for his pirate victim. Ink and blink in glee did the girl around the dragon that ate the pirate. Now all of them are celebrating the death of pirate. Clear? So, and they are, just we can say, they are dancing around the Custard. And here, Custard, the dragon, that ate the pirate. It means that killed the pirate. The Custard, the dragon, had killed the pirate and ate. Means it divided into pieces to the pirate. So he these are the two paragraphs. As we can see here again, reminiscing of the poem Dragon Flagon. Dragon Flagon, he be him victim, garret pirate. So here again A B B. The poet has beautifully described here an imaginative story. In this way, the message is so clear that no one is here covered. If it is demanding for, in the case of, we can say, pirate, if it is demanding for a nice safe case, so it was not for dragon or dragon's Custard's safety. It was about the Belinda and the remaining pet safety because dragon can harm them. But dragon didn't want to harm them. So why he was always demanding for a nice safe case. Clear? And now remaining two paragraphs, two stanza we are going to read, and then we are completing our point. So dear students, here we can see 13 and 14 stanza of this poem, and the last one, 15th stanza, is again repeating stanza from the starting second one. So as we can see here, when Custer the dragon had killed the pirate, so after killing the pirate, every pet animal is coming back and they are celebrating. Now it is their turn. And they are expressing their excuses, telling their excuses and saying if they had also got chance, they were also ready to attack on the pirate. So, but presently up spoke little dog Mustard. Now Mustard is starting to giving excuse. I would have been twice as brave. कि मैं दुगना भागा होता, if I had not been flustered, अगर मैं भागा नहीं होता, डर नहीं होता, and up spoke Ink and up spoke Blink. Now Ink and Blink is also speaking. We would have been three times as brave we think. Means they are thinking. Ink and Blink are thinking that they are three times brave. We would have been three times as brave we think. And Custer said, I quite agree. Custer, the dragon, was listening to them very patiently and saying that yes, I am totally agreed with you, with all of you, that you all are very brave comparatively me. Means you are best. And Custer said, I quite agree that everybody is braver than me. That all of you are very braver than me. Means still now, the dragon, Custer the dragon, has a polite respect for them. Still now, he is not showing his proud and all the things. Still now, he is listening to them and he is accepting their, we can say, ki hum ye kar sakte the, we can do this and that. But still now, he is saying that, yes, I accept it. That all of you are very braver than me. Belinda still lives in her little white house. Belinda is also still living in the same little white house with her little black kitten and her little grey mouse and her little yellow dog and her little red dragon and her really little pet dragon. Means now again the life is normal and Belinda is living with her pet animals, in which first Ink, Blink, Mustard and Custer, all they are living happily. And in the last 15th stanza, we can say that that stanza is repeating from the starting second or third stanza. So I am not writing here again that stanza. And if we are talking about the rhyming scheme of this poem, so in stanza 31 we can say Mustard fluster. So here we can say see, Blink think, D agree me, E. So in starting we have seen AABB. Here we can say AABBCC or CCDDEE. And here house, mouse, wagon, dragon. So again AABB. So dear student, this is the poem, the tale of the Custer the dragon, which was composed by Ogden Nash. Clear? So if you have any doubt, you can ask me and prepare it very well. With best of luck. Have a nice day. Thank you.